Mushrooms. Earthy, tasty, healthy. We've been eating them for hundreds of thousands of years. But recently, our appetite for fungi has, quite literally, mushroomed. A rise in veganism and healthy eating has propelled vitamin-rich mushrooms out of the dark and to the top of the menu. And incredibly, one tiny town has an annual mushroom crop of nearly 200 million kilos. How do they do it? Not quite plant, not quite animal. Scientists put fungi in a kingdom all of their own. They can grow in soil like plants, but they don't need sunlight. And like animals, they consume oxygen, not CO2. Of 140,000 mushroom species, over 3,000 are edible, 75 glow in the dark, and 200, as hippies will testify, have mind-bending hallucinogenic properties. Man. The biggest name in mushrooms is a surprisingly small corner of America. Kennett Square, Pennsylvania. Around this tiny town of just 6,000 people, more than 60 mushroom farms have sprouted up. Between them, they produce more than half of America's total mushroom crop. One of the biggest is South Mill Champs, who harvest 500,000 kilos of mushrooms a week. Shining a light on their humongous fungus crop is the Champs assistant manager, Dennis Melroth.
Mushrooms, they got their own little personality. They're the same, but they're all different, and you have to treat them a little bit different, each one.
Mushrooms were first farmed in Asia in 600 AD. Fast forward 1400 years, and 90% of the shrooms eaten stateside are button mushrooms, making this America's favorite fungi. Buttons are mushrooms that have been picked early, before their canopy, or cap, has opened up and while they're still firm. But growing them is easier said than done. As foragers know, mushrooms are picky about where they pop up. But down on Fungi Farm, they found the perfect growing medium. Chad LaFazia is critical to growing, but he's in charge of muck, not mushrooms. Churning out 140,000 tons of a very special compost every year.
I started on the composting since 2006. We run probably about 12 to 14 hours a day, 7 days a week.
The compost is a mix of hay and straw, and one last ingredient that will put you right off your mushroom risotto. Because each bale contains a top secret amount of chicken poo. Now, it's got to compost in a steaming, stinking bunker.
After the raw ingredients have all been mixed together and water added. To us composters in the mushroom industry, we like to say it smells like money.
We won't dwell on what the rest of us like to say it smells like, Chad. To speed up the 2-week composting process, the bunkers are pumped full of hot air and reach temperatures of 82 degrees Celsius.
So you can see the floor has got slats in there, and each one of these has a hole. There's blowers upstairs in the attic going through the duct that blow air throughout the whole entire bunker. That blower kicked on, and now the air is pushing out of that tunnel. And it's hot.
Heat, oxygen, and moisture provide a reeking paradise for bacteria, which go to work breaking down Chad's steaming mix. I'd give it a few days if I were you.
Every 3 days, we mix the compost. That's because, as you can see, we're losing a lot of moisture. So we try to mix the compost and add more water This is the recycled water that we use. There's all kinds of good stuff in that water that helps break down the raw ingredients.
After 2 weeks, the mix is pasteurized to kill any bad bacteria, concluding its conversion into a compost that's rich in nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus, and ready for growing mushrooms. Mushrooms reproduce via microscopic spores, a bit like pollen, that fall from their gills. In the wild, spores are carried by wind or wildlife. Here, they buy theirs from commercial spore companies. 1.6 million litres of them a year. Chad uses a hopper to dispense an even mix of spores throughout the compost, which is loaded into 154 temperature-controlled growing rooms. Although mushrooms can flourish in sunlight, they don't actually need it, so the rooms remain dark.
Okay, great. Come on in.
Saving thousands of dollars in electricity bills. Each room holds 96 tons of compost and acts like a health spa for some extremely pampered spores. Their first stage of growth is the spores turning into mycelium.
Mycelium is the root structure of the mushroom, and the mushroom is the fruiting body of the mycelium. It's like the apple of an apple tree.
Mushrooms are 92% water, and the thirsty mycelium mustn't dry out if they're going to turn into buttons. So Chad's team add a layer of wet peat moss to retain moisture. But for mushrooms to fruit, Chad must convince the mycelium that it's autumn, all year round.
Apples don't fruit in the middle of winter. Same thing with mushrooms, and that similarity is that we have to create the warmth and the humidity and the right oxygen levels for it to fruit.
They drop the temperature to 16.5 degrees, lower the humidity to 86%, and introduce outside air so CO2 levels don't rise. Remarkably, in these conditions, mushrooms can double in size every 24 hours, which still blows Boss Dennis's mind.
It's amazing how these things grow. You could look at that in the morning, and then the next morning come and look at it, it just grows up like that. That's when it's really satisfying, and you really get to enjoy all your work up to that point. But this is ready to pick. This is the difference. Still a little firm, pretty and white. This is what you want.
Firm and fresh, they're ready for America's healthy eaters. Containing protein, fiber, and B vitamins. How's that for magic mushrooms?